With more holy as our Lord, holy as our Lord, there is more beside our Lord, neither is there any wrong like our God. There is more holy as our Lord. Amen, amen. Father, we just want to thank you. We want to appreciate you for another time in your presence. Thank you for your mercy and glory forever. Thank you for your love. We worship you, Lord. We exalt you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to this your special online service. Tag Destiny Recovery Hour. Destiny Recovery Hour is an hour, is a service whereby we gather together to pray and seek the face of God concerning the plan of God for our life and concerning manifest fulfillment in the name of Jesus. But before we go into the world this evening, this morning, this afternoon, whatever your time horizon all over the continent, I just like you to lift our voice and appreciate the King of Kings. Thank you, I say the Lord of Lords. Bless his holy name. Say, my Father, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I give you all the glory. Lord, I give you adoration. Lord, we just want to thank you. We appreciate you for another time like this in your presence. Oh, Malia Fusaba, Mekusada Bush, Mekusada Bushka. Lord, we thank you. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy, oh Lord. Invisible God. You are the miracle worker. You are worthy, oh Lord. You are worthy. You are worthy, oh Lord. Malia Sedege, Bukulataka, Sharia Buskadaga, Melua Sadaraba, Kuliataka, Mekusiraga, Italiga, Kurashada, Mekulaga, Zahitaga. You are worthy, oh Lord. In Makala Bosa, you are worthy, the King of Kings. You are worthy, the Lord of Lords. You are worthy, the Ancient of Days. You are worthy, the Rose of Sharon. You are worthy, the Lily of Valley. You are worthy, my Father. We appreciate you, Lord. We give you all the glory for another Destiny Recovery Hour service. Makali Asida, Mekurataka, Zeata Kaliga, Indali Kosada, Rotoshagada, Intoziataka, Rotosagada. We worship you, Lord, because your name is Alpha, your name is Omega, your name is Jehovah Jireh, your name is Jehovah Nissi. We thank you for divine plan you have given to us. We thank you for divine plan you will give to us. We thank you for achievement of our divine plan this year. We thank you, Lord, for how far you have helped us in our journey of destiny. Father, we appreciate you, Lord. We lift you up your name. Makuli asadaga, makala gasada, meleke shidabaga, makuli kasenege, mekuli gasada, mekula tashaga. In Jesus' name we give them. Brethren, I still want to give them because why? You are not an accident. I'm not an accident. There is a purpose of God for your life. There is a purpose of God for life. And it's even our divine plan. It is even what is that is called destiny. So I'd like you to cry to God. If you have discovered that, say, Father, I thank you for helping me discover a purpose. I thank you, Lord, for that divine plan but as you have given me. Father, we thank you for as men that be received the purpose of God for their life. That is, they have men that have received the divine plan of God for them. Lord, we thank you for as men that they will discover today. Father, we appreciate you. We give you all the glory because we are nations. We are a chosen generation. We are a royal priesthood. That's what your word says in 1 Peter 2:9. We are not accidental people. We are not a commoner people. We are a nation. We are a generation. A spectacle. People, Father, we thank you for this privilege, for this understanding of who I am in the Lord. Father, of the understanding of what who we are in the Lord. Father, we thank you. Lord, we appreciate you. We say, blessed, 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 and in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to lift up and still cry to God. Say, my Father. My Savior, I want to thank you for another time in your presence, a refreshing time of power, a divine time of revelation. Say, my Father, I want to thank you for a refreshing time in your presence, a time of revelation, a time of receive, to receive your word, a time to pray until something happens. Father, we bless your name. Father, we appreciate you. Meluataska, Bakushagada, Mekusiatoka, Iruasiadaga. bakushagada melukas kada mekusegede melu etusiga makurataka zeata kashaga zeketeleke rotosaga mekusada meluateke. In Jesus' name we pray. Pray, God, lift our voice, Father. Is any we have sinned against you? Please have mercy on me. Anything that will turn against my prayer today, please have mercy. Let your blood cleanse me. Let your blood cleanse us of every unrighteousness, of every impurity. Say, my Father, is any way we have sinned against you, Lord? Let your blood cleanse us of every unrighteousness, of every iniquity, in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit of God, we ask that the blood of Jesus cleanse us, Lord, because you said in your word that is the prayer of the sinner you will not hear. That's what the word says in John chapter 4, 31. You will not hear the prayer of the sinner. Lord, we are coming here. Is there any way we have sinned against you? Let your blood cleanse us of every sin, of every iniquity that will not allow prayer to happen. The word of God, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not answer me. Father, we don't want to regard any iniquity. Let your blood cleanse us of every iniquity in the name of Jesus. The one we know, the one we don't know about. Father, let your blood cleanse us in the name of Jesus. Malibos kabosh belutasidaku makuta ligatuske beluata shaga mekusanganda nege belukata. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to lift our voice this evening and this morning, this afternoon. We are going to cry to God. Say, Father, please have mercy on me. Let sin not truncate my destiny. Let sin not destroy my calling. Say, my Father, every hidden sin waiting to manifest, every hidden sin of the past, it will not destroy my destiny. It will not destroy our destiny. Say, my Father, every hidden sin, every sin that we don't know about, we will not destroy our destiny. It will not destroy our calling. Every demonic aggression as against our destiny and star, we decree in the name of Jesus, cast fire and be destroyed. In the name of Jesus, every unknown sin, every generational sin, they will not stop our destiny fulfillment. They will not destroy our destiny. In the name of Jesus, Father, please have mercy. Lord, please have mercy. Lord, please have mercy. Maliatu saga, belukashiatoko, retu sagada, maliatu saga. In Jesus' name we pray. Brother, in the book of 2 Samuel chapter 18, from chapter 16, 17, 18. 2 Samuel from chapter 16, 17. There was a man called Joab. This Joab was a kind of, let's say, general, a minister of defense for David. But this Joab got intoxicated with power, that he started misbehaving. He started directing. He started controlling David. And not knowing, this was counted against him. And when David was dying, he told his son Solomon in 1 Kings chapter 2, he said, Joab, don't let him go scot-free. Deal with him because of what he did to kill some innocent men. You are going to cry to God. Say, my Father, every sin that I don't know what, every innocent mistake, say, that the enemy is planning to use against my destiny, to use to truncate my destiny. Say, blood of Jesus, deliver me. Blood of Jesus, deliver us. Every sin, oh Lord, every innocent sin, every innocent mistake that the kingdom of darkness gathered together, they want to use against our destiny. Father, let your blood cancel them. Let your blood destroy them. In the name of Jesus, Father, we cry for mercy. We cry for mercy. We cry for mercy against every unknown sin that the devil wants to use to truncate our destiny. We say, let your mercy prevail. Let your mercy prevail. In the name of Jesus, every unknown sin, let your mercy prevail. In the name of Jesus, Malito Sagoda, Roto Shagada. In Jesus' name we pray. Through that story of Joab, it also means there are certain things. Sometimes you did some things and you don't know they are wrong, or sometimes you know that they are wrong. In the case of Joab, he knew it was wrong, and he did it deliberately, and his sin was, it was counted against him, but the sin was, it was not punished immediately. They waited for a particular time to bring that thing out. You are going to cry to God. Say, my father, every deliberate action of mine that was viewed wrongly, every deliberate action of my hand that was viewed wrongly, and the enemy is planning to use against my destiny fulfillment in this 2020 and 2021. Father, by your mercy, deliver me from the conspirators. Deliver us from the conspirators in the name of Jesus. Say, my father, we are crying to you this morning. Every action, every past actions of ours that have been misinterpreted, and they are waiting to use it against your people, to use it against us. Father, let your mercy prevail. Let your blood deliver us. Let your mercy prevail. Let your blood deliver us in the name of Jesus. Makurata shaga, melusagorima, etusaga, lekushada. In Jesus' name we pray. Some years ago, I have a boss, and the boss told me, he said, please, then they tell me something that it doesn't, you're not going to find in the handing over note. Tell me what is not going to be found in handing over note. This is one of the training in the business school. What is that thing that I'm not going to find in handing over note? Some of these things that I'm not going to find in someone's handing over note is something they use against people. They used to truncate destiny. They used to truncate career. They used to stop. You are going to cry to God. Sometimes many of us doesn't know the person that left, your former boss, you never knew what report he has given about you. You don't even know your former boss, the report he has given about you, the one that left the organization. You don't know what he said verbally to the new boss. Maybe that's what is counting against you. So you are going to cry to God. Say, my father, everything I have done in the past, every mistake, every error that the enemy is using against me, enough is enough. You can no longer stand against my destiny. In the name of Jesus, be reversed in the name of Jesus. By mercy of God, avail for me. The mercy of God, avail for you. Say, my father, every sins of the past, every errors of the past, every mistake of the past that they are using against us, Father, let your mercy deliver us. Let your blood avail for us. Let your mercy deliver us. Let your blood deliver us. In the name of Jesus, Malito Saga, Bekushagiado, Mekushahandaka, Mekusahanda, Mekusida, Roto Saga. In Jesus' name we pray. We are still crying to God, brethren. In Isaiah 54, in Isaiah 54, verse 16, he said, they shall surely gather. But if their gathering is not of God, shall be scattered. So you are going to cry to God. Say, Father, every gathering against my destiny fulfillment in the kingdom of darkness, I'm around my neighborhood, in my workplace, Father, this year or next year, Father, scatter them in Jesus' name. Every demonic gathering against our destiny fulfillment, against our destiny discovery, whether in the workplace, from the kingdom of darkness, Father, arise and scatter them in Jesus' name. Because you say you are surely gathering. Because they give their gathering to God of you, it shall be scattered. Every gathering against our destiny, against our glory, from the corpus of earth, from our lineage, from our generation, scatter in the name of Jesus. Scatter every demonic gathering against our destiny, against our division, against the divine plan of God for our life. Father, scatter them. Jesus, scatter them. Patient of day, scatter them. Every conclusion against our destiny, every conclusion against our destiny, against our businesses, against our career, from the kingdom of darkness, scatter them in Jesus' name. Scatter them in Jesus' name. Scatter them in Jesus' name. Malito suta rumose eliatuza mekushada makusada. In Jesus' name we pray. As I was telling you, that story of Joab, when I read it in 2 Samuel chapter 16, 17, 18, he felt that he was doing very well. He felt he was the top of the world. He didn't know that this mistake, this pride, this intoxication of power is being viewed against him. He never knew. After David died, he thought that has come to the head. But Solomon was the one that actually killed him. Why? Because David gave Solomon. Read it. You can read it in 2 Kings chapter 2. David told Solomon, he said, don't allow Joab to go unpunished.
So David did not kill him, he left him because David has a secret with you and he can't do anything against him. There are some people in your organization around you that you know their secret and they can't deal with you. But they're going to give somebody to you, you are going to cry to God, say, my father, anybody that is planning you against my destiny, my career, my business, this year, next year, and years to come, Father, scatter them, destroy their work in Jesus' name. It is written in your word. It says there shall be no enchantment, there shall be no divination again the household of Jacob. And I will see what the Lord has done. It is written in your word. He said, arise, O Lord, let your enemy be scattered. Father, arise, O Lord, every enemy of our destiny, enemy of our career, scatter them in Jesus' name. Scatter them in Jesus' name. Scatter them in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, we are in the presence of God right now. I'm having this very conviction in the spirit. If you know that you have made some genuine mistakes, genuine error that anybody can use against you, I'd like you to go to the prayer of God. In this season, we call on the mercy and the blood of Jesus. Because the Bible says in Colossians chapter 2, yes, verse 14, it says, blotting every handwriting that was contrary and that was against us, and kneeling there to the cross. So I'd like you to cry to God. Say, Lord, let your mercy. Oh Lord, cancel everyone writing. Let your mercy and blood, let your mercy and blood cancel everyone writing that is against my destiny. Your mercy and blood, your mercy and blood, your mercy and blood, let it cancel every handwriting that was contrary, that's against me, that's against you, that's against your calling. Say, Father, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, have mercy, have mercy. Let your blood of Jesus, let it defend us against evil and writing, every contrary word against us in Jesus' name. For every genuine mistake, for every error we have made, let your mercy defend us. Let your mercy defend us. Let your mercy defend us in the name of Jesus. Let your blood avail for us. Let your blood avail for every evil and writing, for every contrary writing. Let your blood, let it wipe it away. Let it wipe evil and writing. Let it wipe evil mistake away. In the name of Jesus, our destiny will not crash. Our destiny will not be truncated. In the name of Jesus, Malitu Sagu, Meluatasha, Makurada, Mekusiada, Melusada, in Tusaga. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to cry to God, say, Father, for everyone that offended, that's waiting to revenge against me, Father. Silence your voice. Say, my father, for every man, for every woman that offended, knowingly or unknowingly, and they refuse to forgive. Father, silence them. Withdraw their strength. Withdraw their power. Father, by your mercy, every man, every woman I have offended, knowingly or unknowingly, and they refuse to forgive, they still keep it in their mind. Father, silence their voice. Withdraw their authority. Withdraw their strength. In the name of Jesus, Matusa Kuta, Eletusa Daba, Rotoshada, Makusada, Benuata. Father, please have mercy. For everyone we have offended, knowingly and unknowingly, that they refuse to forgive us, let your blood defend us and silence the voice of these men, these women who are bent, O Lord, and on revenge against us. Silence their voices. Withdraw their strength. Withdraw their power. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray the same prayer again. In Job chapter 5. In Job chapter 5. He said, God bless you. In Job chapter 5. I want to plead with you. This is a serious prayer. This is not what I planned for. Is there anybody who has vomited this prayer? Please share this prayer to your groups. Share this as you are sharing. Before the end of this month, good news will be shared to you. Share this faith to your groups. Share them to your friends. Encourage somebody to join in the name of Jesus. Because somebody's life will turn around. And when someone's life turns around, it will connect with you in the name of Jesus. You are going to cry to God. Job chapter 5 verse 12. He said, he disappoints the vice of the crafty. Yes. So that the end will not perform their time. Who are the crafty? Yes. The crafty are people who are dining with you daily and evening. But they hate you. The crafty are somebody who pretend to like but doesn't like you. So you are going to cry to God. Say, my Father, my Savior, every crafty around me that is planning evil against my destiny, against my career, Father, disappoint their devices. Disappoint their devices in the name of Jesus. Say, my Father, my Savior, every device of the crafty men, the crafty women surrounding us in business, surrounding our career, disappoint their devices in the name of Jesus. Say, disappoint the device of the crafty so that the eye will not perform the tower. Every crafty man, every crafty woman in our businesses, in our career, in our ministry that surround us, Father, disappoint their devices and disappoint their devices in the name of Jesus. And let the eye not perform the enterprise of shame, the enterprise of disgrace, the enterprise of embarrassment. They are planning. Let them not perform the enterprise. In the name of Jesus, Malito Shika, in the name of Jesus, thank you, Jesus. That career is coming back to life. That career that has been manipulated, that has been destroyed, that has been killed, is coming back to life. It's coming back to life. In the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ, I don't know the person under the sound of my voice. Something has been concluded. Something has been concluded concerning somebody's destiny. In the name of Jesus Christ, who is the one that said a thing when the Lord has not commanded? Jesus Christ said, He said, I'm the life and the resurrection. He is the life and the because Jesus Christ is resurrection and life. Therefore, I click in the name of Jesus Christ on that. Every destiny that has been killed, that has been concluded, and the one announced obituary, because Jesus Christ is the resurrection and life, resurrection will bring it back. In the resurrection that will bring it back. In the resurrection of life will bring it back. In the name of Jesus, Melusadaba, Mekushaka, the resurrection of life will bring every career that is that want to be killed, every business that want to be killed. Resurrection of life bring it back to life. In the name of Jesus, bring it back to life. In the name of Jesus, bring it back to life. In the name of Jesus, Malitusaga, Mekushaga, Makusagada, Meluataka, Mekushege, Mekusaga, Mekusada. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to pray. We are still going to pray. Brethren, the matter of destiny is a matter of life. Destiny is a matter of life. It's a matter of life. The matter of divine plan is a matter of life. So you are going to cry to God and call on God of heaven. Say, my Father, I will not die without fulfilling my destiny. I will not die without not fulfilling my destiny. The divine plan of God for my life as a nation, as a generation, I will not die without not fulfilling Jesus' name. I will not die without not fulfilling Jesus' name. My marital destiny, my career destiny, my business destiny, my financial destiny, I will not die without fulfilling in the name of Jesus. Academic destiny, you will not die without fulfilling. Marital destiny, business destiny, career destiny, ministerial destiny, you will not die without fulfilling in the name of Jesus. May you tasaga, bekusagada, rekushagada. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. In every sector, in every destiny, they are what they call strong men and strong women. They make themselves a strong goal. But the word of God said in that 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 5, 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4, he said, pulling down the strong goal, pulling down the strong goal that was against God, pulling down the strong goal. So you are going to cry to God, say, my Father, every strong goal against my destiny, every strong goal against my business, every strong goal against my career, every strong goal against my marriage, pull you down in Jesus' name. I pull you down in Jesus' name. Every stronghold against the destiny of this, against their career destiny, against their academic destiny, against their business destiny, against their children destiny, we pull them down in Jesus' name. Akalito Saga, we pull them down in Jesus' name. We pull them down in Jesus' Makaloshe. Every stronghold, every strong man that turned themselves to a stronghold in the organization, in the businesses, we pull them down. We pull them down. We pull them down. Every strong man, every strong woman that have turned themselves to a strong goal in organization. Father, we pull them down in the name of Jesus. We pull them down in Jesus' name. Brethren, that 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 5 is verse 5. That 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 5. Remember, he said, casting down imagination and everything that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, bringing to captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. So you are going to pray to God and cry, say, my Father, say, my Savior, any group of people, any strong men and women in my business, in my university, in my career, that I exalted themselves with evil imagination. Evil imagination against me, against my study. Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, pull them down. Father, pull them down. Bring them to captivity. Every evil imagination, everyone with evil imagination, evil talk about our business, about our studies, about our career. Father, bring those evil thoughts, bring that evil mind into captivity. Bring them to captivity in the name of Jesus. Bring them to captivity in the name of Jesus. Bring them to captivity in the name of Jesus. Bring them to captivity. Bring them to captivity. Every evil imagination that wants to exalt itself against God in our life, against God's ourselves. Pull them, Father, put those evil thoughts, put them into captivity in the name of Jesus. Malutuseka, melutakusha, endoko. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we pray. That second Chronicles chapter 10, verse 1. Verse 6. He said, having readiness to avenge all disobedience, when your obedience is full fulfilled. Having readiness to avenge all disobedience, when your obedience is full. We are going to cry to God. Say, Father, for every disobedience, I am crying for mercy again. For every disobedience, I am crying for mercy. Say, Lord Jesus, for every disobedience against your word, Father, I cry for mercy. We cry for mercy today. And Lord, because of our readiness to obey you, let every disobedience be wiped away. Let every disobedience be wiped away. In the name of Jesus, Mali dos gaba, bekushadaga, bekusege, rekosada, rekosoda, rekosida, rekosoda. Father, for everyone disobedient, in readiness, O Lord, of the spirit and body and soul to obey you all the time. Father, let every disobedient, let it be reversed, let it be canceled, let it be declared, every effect of disobedience, let it be declared null and void in our lives, in our careers, in our academies, in our marriages, in our finances, in the name of Jesus. Melutas kada retusegede. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. We are going to lift our voice. Brethren, there are some of us here. There's an evil contention. There's evil contention against your glory. We are going to pray from Psalm 18. Psalm 18, verse 44 or 43. Psalm 18, verse 44. Psalm number 18, in verse 43. Okay? In verse number 43. In Psalm 43 and 44, he talk about delivering up from every strife. He said, deliver from every strife. So you are going to cry. Psalm 18, verse 43. He talk about God deliver me from the striving of people. Say, my father, deliver my destiny from the striving of the strong man. Say, my father, deliver my destiny from the striving of strong men and strong women. Deliver our destiny from the striving, from the strife of evil and strong men. In the name of Jesus. My father, deliver our businesses, deliver our studies, deliver our academies, deliver our children, deliver our finances, deliver our businesses, deliver our career from the striving of men, of people. In the name of Jesus. Every striving, every contention against our destiny, against our career, let there be total deliverance from it. Let there be total deliverance in the name of Jesus. Let there be total deliverance in the name of Jesus. Mali to saga, every striving matoseke, let deliver us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, David was the one that came up with that prayer. He knew what he was talking about for 13 years. Because of the striving of people, he could not mount the throne. So you are going to repeat that prayer. For 13 years, David was running from one group to the other because men were striving against him. Saul and his men, they were striving against him. He could not mount the throne. So you are going to cry to God. Say, my father, every demonic striving in the cold of air does not allow me to receive my breakthrough, does not allow me to enter into my destiny, deliver me this hour. Totally and permanently. My father, every striving of every contention and striving of men does not allow your people to enter into their destiny, to enter into their prophetic destiny. Father, this evening, this afternoon, this morning, let there be total deliverance from of their destiny, of our destiny, from the striving of men, from the striving of women, in the name of Jesus. Let there, from today, Lord Jesus, let there be deliverance from total striving of the men, from our destiny. In Jesus' name we pray. Now, if men are standing against you, it's a small matter. But the whole nation is standing against you, that's a problem. Isaac, in Genesis chapter 26, from verse 27 to 30, the entire Philistine was striving against Isaac. And that was a problem. So you are going to cry to God. Say, my father, my savior, deliver me from the striving of nations against my destiny. Say, my father, deliver me from the striving of nations against our destiny in Jesus' name. Deliver from every striving of nations against our destinies, against our callings in the name of Jesus. Deliver our destiny, our academic destinies, our business destinies, our career destinies, our marital destinies, our children's destiny from the striving of nations in the name of Jesus. Malitusaga Mekuroto Shiga. In Jesus' name we pray. He said, David said, thou hast made me the head of Eden. Ah, you are going to cry to God. David said, God has made me the head of Eden. Say, Father, in that business premises, in that career premises, in that university. Make me the head of everybody. Make me number one. Say, my father, my savior, in that business premises, in that workplace, in that university, in that environment we have found ourselves, make us number one. Make us the head of the healing. Make us the head of healing. Malibostara. Meshulara to say, Mekusada, Bokusadaga, Bekulakushka, Mekulakaska, Bekulakaske, Merukishka, Matsusika. In Jesus' name we pray. For every skeleton, life is coming back. Jesus said, no, Daniel, God said to Daniel and Ezekiel in Ezekiel chapter 37, he said, can this bone live again? God said, and he said, God, do I know? He said, prophesy. For every dry bones, for every dry businesses, for every dry career, in the name that's above every other name, in the name of Jesus, I say this life is restored, flesh is restored to every dry business, every skeleton business, life is restored, every skeleton academic study, life is restored, in the name of Jesus, life is restored, life is restored, in the name of Jesus, mekuzi bokula, merutushkada, bakusagada, bekusegedege, melukuska, alokoshke, in Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. And last part in that Psalm 18, verse 43, he said, the people I do not know will serve me. Say, people whom I have not known shall serve me. Say, Father, as I go to 2021, now in this year, people I don't know, let them serve me. Say, my Father, my Savior, as this year is going to an end, as I enter 2021, the people I don't know, let them serve me. The people you don't know, they will serve us. They will serve us ministerially. They will serve us business-wise. They will serve us career-wise. They will serve us maritally. In the name of, they will serve us academically. In the name of Jesus, Malito Saga, Bekushada, Rekusagede, Makulagoske, Retusagada, Melu Ata, Bakusege, Bekuskede, Bekushada, Adayada, Mekuzadaba, Mekuziadaga, Makushada, people that you don't know, they will serve you in 2019, 2021. People you don't know, they will serve us in 2021. In the name that's above every other name, in the name of Jesus, men that you don't know, women that we don't know, they will serve us in 2021. They will serve us in 2020. In the name of Jesus, they will serve your ministry, they will serve your career, they will serve your home, they will serve your children, they will serve your academies. In the name of Jesus, Letushaga Rotosegeda. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we just want to thank you. Lord, we want to bless your name, appreciate you. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity as we go into your word. That is, speak to us in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, envelope us. Let no man be hard. In Jesus' name we pray. Brethren, I want you to pray before we go into. Say, my Father, my Savior, from this time now forever, Holy Spirit, envelope me. I will not do anything outside the Holy Spirit. Spirit of living God, envelope my action, envelope my decision. And this year is going to end, even as I enter 2021 and forever. Holy Spirit, envelope me. Let flesh be dead. Let Jesus be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Amos chapter 3, verse 7. 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 He said, and the Lord said, Amos chapter 3, verse 7. And the word of God said, surely the Lord God will do nothing, but he revealed his secrets unto his servant, the prophets. The Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord God Almighty, will do nothing, but reveal his secret unto his servant, the prophet. So that somebody will not think, many of us will not misinterpret this. Matthew chapter 16, verse 16 to 18. And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art Christ, the Son of living God. And Jesus answered and said unto him, blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood have not revealed unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. He says, and I say unto thee, thou art Peter, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gate of hell shall not prevail against it. Brethren, Jesus said to Peter, he said, flesh and blood has not revealed this to you. There is a power of revelation. Brethren, the key to unlock door of destiny in 2021, keys to unlock destiny in 2021, one of the key is the key of revelation. Key is an instrument that opens a door. If you want the door of your destiny to be opened mightily in 2021, you must have a revelation. What is a revelation? Revelation is what is made known to somebody. Revelation is something that is made known to somebody. A revelation is something that will make known to somebody. Peter, Jesus Christ was asking Peter, another disciple, who am I? Someone say you are Elias, some say you are Elijah, some say you are Moses. But Peter said, you are Jesus Christ, the Son of God. And Jesus said, Simon by Jonah, flesh and blood has not revealed this thing to you. That is, who Jesus Christ was revealed to Peter alone. And immediately Jesus pronounced a promotion. He said, Peter, upon you I will build the church. Before Jesus Christ was asking them, he never knew. Jesus Christ does not have a mindset of who is going to be set up the church after he has left. So the meaning of that is that when you have insight into God's mind, if you have understanding of, if something has made known to you, it will elevate you. Revelation elevate, beloved. Revelation elevate. When you access revelation, you are elevated. When you accept revelation, you are promoted. When you accept revelation, you are lifted. When you know certain things other does not know, it lifted you up. What differentiates somebody from one to another is power of knowledge. Power of knowledge of the what God is saying is what differentiates one somebody for another person. So when you have an understanding of the revelation of what God wants to do in 2021 concerning your career, concerning your academics, concerning your business, and you go in that direction, you are going to excel in 2021. The key to unlock destiny in 2021, number one key is the key of revelation. And the word of God said in Proverbs 25 verse 2, the word of God said, it is the glory of God to hide a matter. It is the glory of God to conceal a matter. But it is the honor of the king to search it out. Because Revelation chapter 1, 6 said, you and me are king and priest unto God. So the word of God said, it is a matter for God. It's the glory of God to conceal a matter. It's the honor of the king to search the matter out. And the Bible described you and me, Revelation 1, 6, as king and priest unto God. So as a king, we are supposed to search out a secret. We are supposed to bring out, we are supposed to discover a revelation of what God is going to do in 2021 in every aspect of our life and key into that dimension. Brethren, How far you will go, how far we go to that temple is a function of the revelation of God we have. And that Amos 3:7 we said, we read, he said, God will not do anything until he reveals it to his servants and prophets. So what God is going to do in 2021 is available for those who can seek his face. What God is going to do in 2021 is available for those who can seek his face. What God is going to do in medicine, in economies, in business, in career, in academics, is available to those men and women who are ready to discipline themselves, who are ready to be diligent, to know the mind of God. Brethren, revelation is an information. Revelation is a sight. Revelation is an information, and it's about the what you are seeing.
Yes.
Revelation is an information. It's about what you are seeing.
Yes.
God told Jeremiah in Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 11 to 12. He said, what are you seeing? Jeremiah said, I'm seeing how much. God said, you have seen well. May I pray for somebody that concerning 2021, you begin to see well in Jesus' name. You will not see failure. You will not see disappointment. You will not see COVID-19. But you will see what God wants to see in the name of Jesus. Somebody can see wrongly. And wrong sight affects revelation. Wrong sight affects fulfillment of destiny. When you see your destiny as being collapsed before COVID-19, the Bible says, what you see is what you get. What you see is what you get. What you see is what you get. Genesis chapter 13. Genesis chapter 13, verse 14 to 15. Genesis chapter 13, verse 14 to 15. God told Abraham after Lot was separated from him. Yes. He said, just lift up your eyes. Whatever you can see, it will be to you. So your apportionment is a function of your sight. Your apportionment in 2021 is a function of your sight. What you can see in your business, what you can see in your marriage, what you can see in your academics is what will come to you. Are you seeing good? Are you seeing promotion? Are you seeing prosperity? Are you seeing healings? Are you seeing deliverance? Whatever you see is what will come to you. He said, the word of God says, surely, Proverbs 23, verse 15, he says, surely the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. Surely the expectation of a righteous man shall not be cut off. The word of God said, he said, the desire of the righteous shall be granted. What's your desire? What's your expectation in 2021? What are you seeing? What are you seeing? Are you seeing like that blind man in Mark chapter 8, verse 22 to 25, that is seeing human being as a tree? Are you like that man who is seeing a human being as a tree? Because after Jesus Christ touched him the first time, which you need a second touch. Don't see 2021 as a failure year. Don't see as a year of losses. Don't see as a year of death. Because what you see is what you get.
Yes.
What you see is what you get. I'm not the one that said it. The word of God said it. God told Abraham in Genesis chapter 13, 14, 15. He said, whatever you see, you will get. So if you see everything, you get everything. If you see little, you get little. If you see little, you get little. If you see all, you get all. He again went to Jeremiah. In that Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 11, he said, Jeremiah, you have seen well. May you see well in Jesus' name. If for 2020, may I see well. May you see well. May you see well. May I see well in Jesus' name. When you see well, the word of God said to Jeremiah chapter 1, he said, God will hasten. Said he wasting his word to perform what you have seen. That Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 11, I read it to you. He said, moreover, the word of God came unto me. Say, Jeremiah, what seest thou? And I said, I see a rod of almond tree. Then said the Lord, thou art seen well. For I will hasten my work to perform it. So what do you see is what you will receive. If Jeremiah have not seen a mud tree, it's whatever he said that will be performed to him. Whatever you see is what will be performed for you. So that is why, the next question I'm asking myself is that, how do I see well? How do I see well? How do I see well? How do I see well for 2021? How do I see my destiny? What do I see in my career in 2021? What do I see in my business in 2021? In view of COVID-19, what do I see? Am I seeing what the world is seeing? I'm seeing what God is seeing. How do I see? How do you see 2021? What can help our side in 2021 is the word of God. What will help our side in 2021 is the word of God. Because why? In Psalm 33 verse 4. In Psalm 33 verse 4. The word of God said. He said, for the word of the Lord is right. And all the work are done in truth. For the word of God, the word of the Lord are right. The word of the Lord are right. And all his work are done in truth. The same Psalm, Psalm 119, he said in verse 11, he said, the word of God have I hidden in my heart that will not sin. Psalm 119 verse 11, he said, the word of God have I hidden in my heart that I will not sin. If you see evil in 2021, it's a sin. If you see for yourself, because you are not believing God, because the word of God said, say it to the righteous. Isaiah chapter 1 verse 19. Say it to the righteous, the one that's living godly life, the one that is faithful, that he, and say it to the righteous, he shall be well with him, and he shall heed the good of the land. What are you saying? You see well when you see from the word of God. You will see when you see from the word of God. And why am I saying this to you? The word of God will help your sight. How much of the word of God you read will help you. Deuteronomy verse 11 verse 18. That Deuteronomy chapter 18. Deuteronomy chapter 18 verse 11. The word is when I talk about this God, I was shocked. That Deuteronomy chapter 18 verse 11. He said, the word of God have I put on my heart. Say, God have mercy. Say, the word of God. Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 18. Deuteronomy chapter 11, verse 18. Say, therefore, shall ye lay up this word in your hearts. Lay this word of God in your hearts, in your soul, and bind them for a sign upon your hand, that they may be a frontier between your eyes. If your word of God is in your hearts, if you meditate on the word of God in your heart, you cannot see evil in your business. You cannot see evil in your career. You will see from the word of God perspective. That's Psalm 119 verse 1. He said, the word of God is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. The word of God will shape your sight. Your word of God will shape your sight. The word of God will shape the sight of your career. The word of God will shape the sight of your business. The word of God will shape everything about you. A lot of people this year, in this year of COVID-19, so many people have gotten so many great things. Change jobs, travel abroad, inside 6 months COVID-19. Because somebody is holding on to the word of God.
Yes.
When men are said, there's a casting down.
Yeah.
For me and you, there shall be a lifting up. That's what the word of God says. Jeremiah and Job 22, verse 29. Job said, when men are said there's a casting down, for you and me, there shall be a lifting up. I like you to cry to God, say, my father, from this season, I see from the word of God. I see my business for what the word of God say. I see my career with what the word of God say. I see my career with the word of God say. In the name of Jesus, if you are a child of God and you're a student, when everybody is failing a course, remember the word of God say in Psalm 119 verse 99. Psalm 119, they say, God will give you more understanding than your teachers. That's what the word of God say. For you as a student, either you're a student, either you are studying masters, you are doing anything. Say, the word of God says in Psalm 119 verse 99. Psalm 119 verse 99. He said, God will give you understanding more than your teachers. You will know more than your teachers. So even because you study, it's tough, it's difficult. The word of God say you have understanding more than your teacher. That's your testimony. You hold on to the word of God and he will give you a bearing. He will give you a direction how you can have understanding more than your teachers. Oh, in your office, things are tough now. Oh, it's because of COVID-19. It's in situations like this that people like that Joseph excel. People like Daniel excel. They were killing people. They were killing wise men in Babylon, in Daniel chapter 2. And they were about to kill Daniel. And they said, Daniel, you must interpret this dream. And he got understanding. Why? Because the Bible says, Daniel has spirit of excellence. If you're a worker, if you're an employee and a player, you have for the spirit of excellence. That's what the word of God says about you. So you see your business career from the excellent perspective. Nobody fired an excellent man. Nobody fired an excellent man. Nobody fired an excellent man. So how do you see your marriage in this season? What did the word of God say? The word of God say your marriage should be like Jesus Christ loving the church as you also submitted to your husband. That's what the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 20 to 25. So you don't see problem, but you see what the word of God say. That's number one. Number two, because that's how to shape our sight. What you hear, what you read will affect your sight. What you hear, what you read will affect your sight. That is why the advertisement company, that's why they always put in all kind of picture in billboard. Because to keep you reminding you of that particular product they are selling. The reason why they use motion picture in advertisement is that they want you to keep on remembering that picture and remember the product they are selling. So what you see on daily basis, what you look at on daily basis, what you read on daily basis has a function of affecting your sight. If you spend more time on the Bible, you cannot be seen with nonsense. You can't see evil. If you study your Bible more, if you read your Bible more, when these people are seen as a casualty, you are seeing opportunity. You are seeing breakthrough. You are seeing greatness. But when you spend most of your time on the DSTV, on all those fake news, on all those dreadful news, your sight will be sight of evil. Will be evil sight. When you read things that everything they say is bad, everything, it also affects your sight. What do I mean your sight? It will affect your dream life. It will affect your dream life. If you watch much of dreadful news, you listen to much of dreadful news, your dream life will be so bad, or if it's terrifying. Because that's what you see all the time. That's why we encourage us to read Bible more. But if you read Bible more, you only see good revelation from God. You only see good revelation from God. So you have to, for your sight to be shaping, for you to see well, to hear, for God to make things known to you, you must stop some watching some things that will color or affect your divine sight. You must spend less time in dreadful news, in dreadful things that will give a gloomy picture, and spend more time on the word of God, on the Christian literature, on the messages of God, men of God. Spend more time listening to them, reading them. It's going to affect your revelation. It's going to affect your dream life. It's going to affect your vision. So I pray for you in the name of Jesus Christ. In this season, God Almighty, we give you the grace to begin to spend more time in the study of the Word of God. In the name of Jesus, you spend more time studying the Word of God. In the name of Jesus, when you watch what you see, when you study the Word of God more, you see good things. You see revelation about 2021. Number two, thing that you must do to shape your sight in this season is to make sure you listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. And this also is a prayer, is a follow-up to the Word of God. After studying the Word of God, we do what we call meditation. And what is meditation? Meditation simply means making an inquiry and say, God, what are you saying through this word to me? What do you want me to do in the business? What do you want to do in my career? What do you want to do in my academic life? What do you want to do in my marriage? You keep on making inquiries, asking God questions, and meditate, stay in His presence. When you do that, a voice of the God will come to you. A gentle spirit will come to you, which is the Holy Spirit. And it will come to you as a voice of the Spirit. Acts chapter 8, verse 29. It will be a voice in your spirit. And when you hear the voice of the Spirit, it will give you a revelation. It will make something known to you. Yes. And I give you an example. Many people are planning to do so many things next year now. But many people have not consulted God that matter. Many people are planning to do so many this year, but they have not asked God. They have not consulted God in this matter. The only way to have a stress-free 2021 is whatever you are doing, get them to know the mind of God on that matter. Get to know what God is saying on that matter. And you can do that through the study of the Word of God and as the voice of the Holy Spirit minister to you, as the voice of the Holy Spirit brings you. Now listen, for this just 2 points, we continue next week. I need you to know that hearing God is not a 1 minute exercise. Hello? I need to let you know that you want to know mind of God. You want God to reveal His plan for you in 2021 concerning your home, concerning your marriage, concerning your career, concerning your academics. It's not a 1 minute exercise. It's a communication process. You don't go to communicate with somebody in an hurry. He will not get what you are saying. You will not have a communication. Husband and wife cannot stay, and the husband is an hurry to leave. The wife will not understand what the husband is taking, neither the wife will understand. Knowing the mind of God concerning a matter, you want God to reveal what happened to you in every aspect of your life in 2021. It requires a diligence. It requires diligence. It requires a business-like approach. Romans 12:11. He said, we should not be slothful in business. It requires, we should not be slothful in our hearing God. We must be diligent. We must be business-like. Our heart must be made up to hear God on the matter. You don't go to the presence of God without a serious business mind and expect to come up with something. You don't want to know what is happening in 2021 and you need to make it a play of fear and expect to hear anything. That's why you see so many great men of God, when they go toward the end of the year like this, they step aside. They go on a retreat. They go to a solitary place to hear God in a business approach, in a very serious manner. So, for you to hear God on a matter, as you study the Word of God, it must be in the form of diligence. It must be business-like. It must be a serious matter. Your heart must be made up to hear, to go in and take something out. You can't go into the presence of God making up your mind to hear something and come back and not hear anything. You can't go that you can't pick your Bible that I want to know something on this matter with a business mind. And at the end of the day, of the time you spend in the presence of God, you don't hear anything. It's not possible. So I'd like you to know that if you want to hear God, you want to know His mind on every facet of your life in 2021, you must be a business life. Your heart must be made up. Romans 12:11, your heart must be made up. And you can't go into the presence of God to know what is going to happen to you in 2021 when you are not a born-again Christian. It's a criteria. You are there, you have not surrendered your life to Jesus Christ, and you want to know what will happen to you in 2021. Then the first thing to do is to give your life to Jesus Christ. And I'd like you to pray this prayer along with me. Join me. Say this prayer after me. If you want to give your life to Jesus, say, Lord Jesus, I come here as a sinner. I acknowledge that I'm a sinner, that my sin, my mother conceives me. And I have that the blood of Jesus wash away my sin, cleanse me of every impurity. I boldly declare I am born again, I am saved, and washed by the blood of Jesus. You pray this simple prayer, please. You see our numbers on the page. Call us, send a free WhatsApp message. You can even send a message on the Facebook. We'll get in touch with you. Let us have your number. We'd like to pray with you and support in this your new Christian journey. Everyone's rejoicing for your salvation today. And I say a big congratulations to you for surrendering your life to him today. But please call up. You must be born again. You must be diligent. Your heart must be made up to hear God. And thirdly, you must be willing to be led. You must be willing to be led. Yesterday I was talking about John 10:27.
Yes.
Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. Without you following them, there is no way you can be led. You can't know the mind of God. You are not ready to be led. If you are not ready to follow Jesus Christ, there is no way you can know the mind of God. You must be diligent. You want to hear God on the matter, you must be diligent. You must be serious about it. Your heart must be made up that you want to hear God on the matter. Number two. Number three, you must be born again. And I want to close with this. You must be meek. God can only direct, can only guide the meek in the heart. Psalm 25:9. It's only when you are meek in the heart that God can direct and order your steps. If you are too proud, if you feel God's decision or thoughts or idea to you is stupid, you can't be led. You can't be directed. You can't know his mind. Sometimes God tells us, even as men of God, some very thing that you cannot imagine. But because we have understood the voice of God over the years, we don't take it for them. We know this is God's voice. And they do come to pass. I pray that today for someone that in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that from this season, you will not just hear God, you will follow in Jesus' name. You will follow his instruction, you will follow his guide in the name of Jesus. Brethren, this is very important as I close, because why? For your destiny is a long-term journey. And every year we enter to, there are some milestones that God wants you to achieve in your destiny fulfillment in each year. So, and the key is to know which of your milestone destiny plan that God wants to achieve is the revelation. So that you don't go, you don't be like Moses, who went ahead of God to go and kill an Egyptian to start the deliverance. When the time has come, that is sent to 40 years exile. So for every man that knows where he's going in life, you know the plan of God for your life. And for every year that is coming, you must understand, you must know the mind of God, you must have a revelation at what kind of milestone in your journey that God wants you to fulfill that year. And that comes to why we need revelation. In your destiny, journey, there will be several things you want to do, that God wants you to do. But every one of them has an appointed time to be done. And the power of revelation will let you know which one is 2020, which one is 2021, which one is 2022, which one is 2023. And in 2021, it will let you know which one must be done in January, which one will be done in March, which one will be done in September, which one will be done in December. That's what the power of revelation does for you. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, as many people that have discovered the plan of God for their life, that God himself will speak to you, will give you an understanding, will reveal to you the secret of your destiny fulfillment in Jesus' name. Peradventure, you have not discovered your divine plan for God for your life. You also need the revelation. Until Moses had a revelation and encounter with God in Exodus chapter 3, he never knew he was supposed to be a prophet to a nation and a deliverer. He was a sheep, a shepherd man, not that he was supposed to be a deliverer for his own nation. Until Apostle Paul encountered God on the way to Damascus, he never knew he was supposed to be the 12th disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. By power of revelation, God revealed himself to Apostle Paul. Not that somebody told him he was on his way to Damascus. In Acts chapter 9, verse 1 to 17, he was running to kill, going about to kill the saint again. God appeared to him in an encounter and revealed himself to him. May I pray for somebody that God will reveal himself to you. Even at this year, it's going to an end in Jesus' name. He will reveal himself to you. He will reveal his plan for your life. Amen. He will reveal his plan for your business. Amen. He will reveal for next year. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Yes. And as we close, I'd like God to cry and pray to God. Say, my Father, my Savior, Lord, I cry out to you. Please give me the grace to receive every revelation from you. Every revelation, every guidance, every direction from you concerning this year and 2021. Concerning our destiny, Father, give us the grace to receive that revelation. To receive that revelation. In the name of Jesus, we will not be manipulated. We will not be tossed away by the situation on ground, but we will be directed and guided by the Holy Spirit. In the name of Jesus, Father, help us to decode parables that you'll be speaking to us. Help us to decode revelate dreams you'll be speaking to us concerning our future, concerning our destiny, concerning our business, concerning our children, amen, concerning our academy, amen, concerning every aspect of our life. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father Lord. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I want to thank God for your life for listening to the telecast. The Lord bless you mightily. For those of you who have shared these pages today, I want to thank God for your life. I cry to God this morning, this evening, this afternoon for you, that all of you that watch this telecast today, you will testify in Jesus' name. Revelation will come to you. Knowledge of what God wants you to do now will come to you. In the name of Jesus, I cover your testimony with the blood of Jesus. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For those of us who have not been sharing this thing, I'd like you to go to our social media pages. The Facebook page is just, it's called RCCG Kololo, Kampala, Uganda. Follow us, like our page, share our page, and comment. As you do that, the same prayer will follow you. Good news will follow you. Favor will follow you. Go to our YouTube channel, RCCG Kampala. Subscribe to our channel. Like the video, comment. You are not liking us. You are liking the good news there. And good news will follow you. Go to the Instagram page called RCC Kampala. Instagram is RCC Kampala. As you follow that Instagram page, good news will follow you. Go to our Twitter page at RCC Kololo UG. As you follow that page, greater thing will follow you. Just for many of you that have a prayer request on that platform, God will answer your prayer. God will answer your prayer. Amen. You will testify in Jesus' name. All of you that have taken your time to come on this platform today, mercy will follow you.
Amen.
Greatness will follow you.
Amen.
Goodness will follow you.
Amen.
Every goodness in this week, receive the fullness of
it.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Lord bless you.
Amen.
The Lord keep you.
Amen.
Lord's consecrate to shine, amen, upon you and lift the calendar upon you. Till we see you tomorrow, 6:30, East African time, 4:30, West African time for prayer meeting. The Lord be with you and keep you.
Amen.